somebody this week. How many of you are going to vote? And how many of you are going to go celebrate Pride? I feel like someone should have really told us that Pride was just right after we were here, because we would have stayed. I know, we have a gig. We have to fly back to Toronto to play a show. But I really do hope all of you have an amazing Pride. We were off last week, and so I don't want to be a total bummer, but I would be remiss to not at least mention slightly that we're just devastated and sad. So sad about, there was so much loss. I mean, the world, obviously, there always is. Every day is a tough day if you go looking for bad news. But we were specifically really just horrified and so sickened by what happened in Orlando the whole weekend, both nights. Because obviously, there was a performer that was shot selling merchandise, and then obviously 100 people were mowed down in Orlando, and it's awful and it's sad. I know most of you, I'm sure there's not anyone, unless you're under a rock, that you wouldn't know that that happened, but we feel like at this time it's really important to say that you shouldn't be afraid and you shouldn't feel bad. I mean, you should feel bad about what happened, but not about yourselves. I saw a lot of people online talking about being scared and feeling bad, and I just thought to myself, this is a very important time in history where we can't become apathetic. We have to continue to push forward and sort of... that have it a lot worse than us, but I just feel like this is a time to remember that we still have to be strong, our community has to be strong, our allies have to stand with us. We have to remember that there are lots of people out there that would do terrible, terrible things, and my instinct the day after the shooting was to sort of pull back a little bit. I had a moment of, for the first time in a very long time, where I was with my girlfriend and was like, I don't want to hold hands, I don't want to, it was a terrible feeling. Made me sick because it was the first time in my adult life that I felt scared. And I'm not afraid. It went away very quickly. I'm not afraid. I'm proud of who we are. We've been in the industry. We've been in the industry a long time. And maybe because of who we are, we've heard about awful, sick, terrible things that happen to LGBT people all the time, and it keeps us fighting, and it gives us extra purpose. We're not just playing music to play music. We're intentionally out there, I hope, being role models and helping move things forward and helping to enact change. But we couldn't do it without your support, whether you know it or not, by supporting us, be it for one record or one song just today or for the last 17 years, you helped to make change, you helped to clear the mainstream, you helped to get women like us. There's still a lot of people who are being oppressed and hurt. So I hope you'll continue to be motivated. I hope you'll continue to be present and fight with us. And I hope you go out and celebrate Pride every day, but especially this weekend. It's more important than ever before for us to stand together as a community. So we're sending you much love if you really do well. That's amazing. All the people in the audience who have felt bad, or who the next day after Orlando, or any tragic, awful LGBT hate crime, if you felt bad, don't feel bad about yourself. Don't. There's nothing wrong with you. You're wonderful. We love you. Older businessman with $1 million, we love you. Don't feel bad about yourself. Yes, right, we probably love you as well. We'll bring it back up again by singing this super sad song.
I've seen many misunderstandings of this, you should know this. I've broken down, brought you back before you had a chance. Forget the bottom line, moving past is giving notice. I have to go, yes, I know the feeling, know you're leaving. Come on, girl, I'm calling you to sing. Caps are standing on the edge of soon or late, I want my back. Imagine that. A million hours left, I think of you, I think of that. Hold up, I'm calling you to say, I'm capsized.